appreciate you guys. We realize you all went to a great deal of trouble you don't normally go to.
All right, so we're going to pull out of this just a little bit of housekeeping for some of these Nevada Department of Correction folks. But while we just have a couple of minutes left, Eric Guster has been seated and is graciously joining us here as well. Haven't heard from you yet. To all of the above, the man is, granted parole, could be walking out as a free man as early as October 1. What do you think of all this?
It was due to be granted parole, but he almost talked himself back into prison. He was very combative, which I was tweeting the entire thing, and what we call in criminal defense, you're going to walk yourself back into the cell. He had the key to his own cell. He was combative. He tried to explain away the robbery, which in our judicial system, once a verdict is rendered, that is a verdict. You can't say, well, I really didn't mean to rob anyone. You did it. Just say, I'm sorry. But he's very fortunate that they didn't hold that against him. Okay. I was a little nervous for him.
Randy Zellin, I have 1 minute until I'm up against the lead here. I mean, I understand when the victim slash friend testified and essentially said, hey, I want to pick you up from prison, sort of case closed.
That was an unscripted, unrehearsed, such a moving moment, keeping in mind that no matter what O.J. Simpson did today, we would be criticizing him. If he checked off every box, was perfectly scripted, said all the right things, we get up and say, look how scripted he is. Look how ridiculous. He was human. He was real. He was him. He went to trial. He protested his innocence. And you know something? He checked off every box on the risk factors. It's all about security versus rehabilitation. It's time for him to go home.
Areva, 20 seconds.
I don't know where Randy has been, but thank you and welcome to the program, Randy. That's what I've been saying all morning. Seriously, though, Brooke, remorse is not a factor. I'm glad they cleared that up.
Okay. Eric, quickly, anything else?
He's lucky. I mean, he did check all the boxes, but these are humans, and they have to vote. It's a human judgment that they have to give. And all of us who practice criminal law know that sometimes judges and parole boards, things may be all right, things may check all the boxes, but they may vote against us.
Thank all of you so much. It has been a wild day here watching what's happened there in Lovelock Correctional Facility in Nevada. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Thanks for being with me.